bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time. Shelter as we go.
Dear Saray, I can't believe today has finally come. A day that, since I was a child, I only dreamed existed. In our love story, you have stolen my heart, captivated my eyes, and brightened my future, giving me hope many more times than I ever could have asked for. As an undeserving man, this absolutely took my breath away. You were exactly what I needed, and God Himself opened my eyes to see you perfectly. At the end of the day, all roads in my heart and in my life lead to you, and it's as if every single moment of my life stepped me one step closer to you. And after a long journey, 22 years later, I finally find myself at the front door of my home. I will stay strong in my commitment to the Lord to be a man of the house, and I will cherish your heart each and every day, as if it was our last, until we grow old and gray together and the Lord takes us home. Saray Ariola, I love you for all that you are, all that you have been, and all that you are yet to be. You are sky filled with stars, and my sky is finally full of stars tonight. You have called me home, so here I make my resting place in you. I love you, Saray.
You've changed my life in a way only a love that is unconditional, reckless, patient, and kind can. In you, I've seen the face of God. In my darkest moments, your love provided a hiding place, a haven for me to rest. And you've held me in moments most would have walked away. You're the first person I was ever able to bear my soul with. Every night you would sit with me patiently waiting, hoping and seeking to learn more and to dive deeper with me. And every day your love pours over me and makes me feel as though the world is at my feet. You make me feel as though nothing is too far or out of reach, that my dreams are possible and that hope can move mountains and love can surpass any border. Anyone can be with someone when it's easy and good, but to stick with someone even when it's not takes dedication. The love you show me always points me back to God. And the way He loves His church Each day you remind me of that sacrificial love. I love you, Jeremy. And I couldn't imagine anyone who's more husband material than you. I'm excited for all that life holds by your side, because loving you has been one of my greatest blessings. I love you.
Now it is my distinct pleasure and joy to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy and Saray Neipp. Let's all welcome them with an applause.
Jeremy, clearly in some way or another, you both have made a substantially positive influence on all those attending this ceremony today, and we are all present here in this moment to return that positive influence, to celebrate and support you both. So congratulations and love you too.
It has truly been a joy to witness and be a part of your guys' love story, and I'm so excited to watch how the Lord continues to handwrite your guys' love story.
And so as your guys' official third wheel, or front wheel, if I can say so myself, Jeremy, you are by far the most devoted guy I've ever met. Thank you for loving my best friend as you do. And Saray, I have never seen you so devoted to a person, and tonight is such a big statement of how far that love goes. The fact that she created with her own bare hands the dance floor on which she will have the first dance with her husband makes me be so reassured that you will not only create a beautiful dance floor, but that you will also construct a great home for your husband to come to, and a great nest and a safe haven for your children to be raised in. And my prayer for you both is that when you find yourselves under the weight of things unknown and unseen, that you will stand firm in knowing that God will lead you right where you need to be. That you may stand in your strongest posture and see your hardest times as more than just times you fell, but a range of mountains that you learn how to climb side by side. Congratulations, you guys.